The excitement, the tension building, the Olympic Center filling to capacity. The face value of a top ticket for tonight's game, $67.20. Outside, they're exchanging hands at three times the face value. Hello again, everybody. I'm Al Michaels along with Ken Dryden. It should be a great night. I'm sure there are a lot of people in this building who do not know the difference between a blue line and a clothesline. It's irrelevant. It doesn't matter because what we have at hand, the rarest of sporting events, an event that needs no buildup, no superfluous adjectives. In a political or nationalistic sense, I'm sure this game is being viewed with varying perspectives, but manifestly, it is a hockey game. The United States and the Soviet Union on a sheet of ice in Lake Placid, New York. Ken, some of your thoughts before the game.
Well, Al, for the U.S. team, it's really discovery time. It's one thing to be young and promising, and it's quite another to be good. And in the next 2.5 hours, the U.S. team players will go through perhaps the most difficult and demanding yet exhilarating time of their lives. They will be playing against a very good team, a team that's better than they are. And after that time, after it's all over, this team will find out an awful lot about themselves. They'll simply find out how good they are.
Taking it away for the U.S. Pavlich up ahead to Schneider. Shot goes in for Schneider. That's the type of goal you don't expect somebody like Tretiak to give up. And the United States ties the game at 14:03 in the period.
Well, once again, it's Pavlich and Schneider combining. A long shot from a fairly severe angle, catching Tretiak in the top glove side. He's well out, he's in good position, although he was moving a little bit in the opposite direction to where the shot went. Here we can see it again in the top corner.
Krutov for the Soviet Union, that made it 1-0. Long shot, the easy save by Tretiak, but Johnson is there and scores with 1 second to play in the period. Right now the clock shows nothing, but it was stopped at one when we looked up as the goal was scored. Right now it shows nothing as the period apparently has come to an end. But the United States has tied the game.
A big, big goal for the U.S. team. Ken Morrow took a shot from the other side of center right, or I'm sorry, it's Dave Christian, knowing that there was almost no time on the clock. But the rebound comes right out to Mark Johnson, who goes wide of Tretiak to tie it up. Very careless rebound, an uncharacteristically careless rebound by Tretiak. There you see it again as he sweeps wide and
perhaps their final rush on this power play opportunity. 13 seconds left in the penalty. The shot begins, followed by Johnson. They score!
Goal that absolutely came out of nowhere. The U.S. team did not seem to be threatening. The puck went to Starikov, the Soviet defenseman, who should have had very good control of it, but he lost it. There's Silk. Now watch the puck go to Starikov. He's in good shape with it, but he loses it right onto Johnson's stick and in the net. Here we see it again. Silk upended, but getting the puck to Starikov, the rebound to Johnson and in.
Snyder, Buzz, long slap shot, saved by Mushkin.
The U.S. team is depending a little bit too much now on Jim Craig. He's making too many good saves.
Arruzioni scores! Mike Arruzioni!
Here's Arruzioni using the defenseman as a screen. A good low shot. Just the kind of goal that Arruzioni scored about 2 weeks ago against the Soviets in Madison Square Garden. There's Pavukin going down to try to block the shot. It goes
28 seconds. The crowd going insane. Karlamov shooting it into the American end again. Morrow is back there. Now Johnson, 19 seconds. Johnson over to Ramsey. Vigiletinov gets checked by Ramsey. McClanahan is there. The puck is still loose. 11 seconds. You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow up to Silk. 5 seconds left in the game.
Do
you believe in miracles? Yes!
Unbelievable.
pictures. Teams congratulating each other after the game. The crowd still roaring. Look at Jim Trey.
Players just don't know how to express their emotions now. They're just jumping around. Unbelievable.
The United States hockey team, average age 22. Herb Brooks, head coach. Craig Patrick, assistant coach. Unknown, totally anonymous, a week and a half ago. Look at Herb Brooks.
No notes tonight.
Oh, my. Jim Craig, they're still undefeated. They've got 3 points now. They've got their fate in their own hands. They'll take on Finland Sunday. The USA champ. Just incredible. 11 o'clock. Sunday morning, Eastern time. The U.S. against Finland. There's O'Callaghan. So the United States has done it. Defeating the Soviet Union, the most improbable circumstance you could ever have imagined before these Olympics started. The final score, the USA 4, the Soviet Union 3.